This is All India Radio Shillong, the Northeast News Bulletin, read by Miranda Blah. In Meghalaya, 36 COVID-19 positive patients were detected yesterday, taking active cases up to 547. 32 new cases were detected in East Khasi Hills, including 12 BSF and 1 Armed Forces personnel and 19 civilians. 2 more cases were detected in East Jaintia Hills and 1 each in West Garo Hills and Ribhoi districts. As per assessment of the health authorities, there is no community transmission suspected in Meghalaya as yet, even as people have been urged to strictly adhere to safety protocols. A 3-day lockdown started in Shillong and its adjoining areas yesterday to carry out extensive contact tracing. Meanwhile, the East Khasi District Magistrate has stated that the LPG delivery workforces are exempted from the purview of the containment orders. However, they are to strictly follow all safety protocols issued by the Government of Meghalaya in the Health and Family Welfare Department. Nagaland registered 1 more COVID-19 fatality, taking the death toll to 5, and 46 new cases were reported yesterday. Nagaland as of now has 1,385 confirmed cases, out of which 811 are active. 20 more patients also recovered from the disease yesterday, taking the number of recoveries to 569 in the state. In Manipur, the COVID-19 pandemic has been getting worse day by day, with more people who do not have travel history testing positive of the virus through local transmission. A 14-day complete lockdown and curfew is underway in the state, and local transmission has made the city of Imphal lifeless. Local transmission is being reported from many places in Manipur, including the Chief Minister's Secretariat, other government offices and the Manipur University too. Reputed hospitals, Regional Institute of Medical Sciences, Jawaharlal Nehru Institute of Medical Sciences and many district hospitals have also reported positive in patients, doctors and other healthcare staff through local transmission. These hospitals have been now restricted their healthcare services and initiated contact tracing and testing for COVID-19. In Assam, 7 persons succumbed to COVID-19 infection yesterday. Health Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma said that the death toll has gone up to 86. The minister said that there are 8,085 active cases in the state. Meanwhile, the Assam government has started 60 more screening centres in Guwahati. In Assam, over 22 lakh people have been affected in the third wave of floods, though the situation has improved slightly. One more person lost his life yesterday, taking the death toll due to floods to 103. Golpara, Dubri, Barpeta are among the worst affected districts. Over 1 lakh hectares of crop areas are also marooned. 45,000 people are taking shelter at government-run relief camps. Relief measures are being intensified at flood-affected districts by the administration. Rice, pulses, mustard oil, salt and drinking water are being given regularly to the flood-affected people. Sikkim reported 10 new COVID-19 cases yesterday, taking the state's tally to 555, an official told PTI. Director General cum Secretary Health Dr. Pempa T. Bhutia said that all new cases have been admitted to various hospitals and COVID care facilities. As per reports received yesterday, there are 380 active COVID-19 cases in Sikkim, where 174 patients have recovered and one has succumbed to the disease. The nation remembered former President Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam on his death anniversary yesterday. Popularly known as the People's President and the Missile Man of India, Dr. Kalam passed away in Shillong on the 27th of July 2015 while delivering a lecture to the students in the Indian Institute of Management. Vice President M. Venkaya Naidu paid tributes to former President Dr. Kalam on his death anniversary yesterday. In a series of tweets, the Vice President said Dr. Kalam's contributions towards the nation building will always be remembered. Home Minister Amit Shah and Information and Broadcasting Minister Prakash Javadekar paid tributes to the noted scientist and teacher Dr. Kalam. Meghalaya Chief Minister Conrad K. Sangma in a tweet paid tributes to the former president and said that he was the people's president who inspired the young generation with his knowledge, ideology and humility. And with that, we end the Northeast News Bulletin, which came to you from the Shillong station of All India Radio. Have a nice day.